And welcome back, everyone, to the Model Works. Hope everyone had a good week. Hope you are well. We have a different video this morning. I wanted to do this video about... This came about from a couple of questions that I had from subscribers. I had a couple of emails and I had a comment in one of the videos, I believe. It's been a while back. And I got another one this week from someone who was asking about or making comment about they were confused about the numerical numbering system of the Paasche airbrushes, that why is it different from one airbrush brand to another, or one airbrush model to another with the Paasche. And I don't know why, other than the fact that the guy asked me why don't they just do it by millimeter and not worry about, well, the reason why is they sell their needle nozzle caps in sets. Which I guess they could do it by millimeter, but rather than do it that way, they just do it a 1, 2, or 3, or 1, 3, and 5. That's how the confusion, I think, came about with them. And he was wanting to know, what the difference was and what they were. He couldn't find anything, which Paasche doesn't do a lot of advertising as far as the millimeter size of the different combinations. It's out there. You just got to know where to look. It's on their website. Especially when you go to look for replacement parts, like needles and nozzles and what have you, because you can get them. You can get the individual needles, nozzles, or you can get the whole set, which you have to make sure you have to do. You have to change the nozzle caps as well as the needles and the nozzles themselves. And a lot of airbrushes are that way, or airbrush manufacturers. Do it that way. This guy had a Talon, which is the sister airbrush to the Paasche Vision. It's a double action internal mix airbrush. They are pretty much the same airbrush. They share the same needle nozzle cap combos. Each one shares the same. The trigger on the Vision is it's a little bit different. It's more ergonomic. It's slanted to the front and it gives you a little more natural feel. Whereas the trigger for the Talon is more rounded with the middle of it, submerged, I guess is the word. Cut out, contour, whatever you will call it. My brain's not working this morning, but the Vision trigger is slanted toward the front and has the grooves cut, which makes it a little bit better for you when you're using the gun. Other than that, they're pretty much the same guns. You can swap the needles out and put the guts out from one end to the other, and you have the same thing. You can change this trigger, order this trigger, and put it in a Talon, you got basically a Vision. So I just like the Vision better. I like the black, and then, of course, it's got the Vision, etched into the body of the gun with it on the cup as well, the paint cup. So now the Vision and the Talon use needle combinations that are numbered 1, 2, and 3. Now, if you're taking notes, the number 1 combination is 0.25. The number 2 combination of needle nozzle cap is 0.38. And the number 3 combination needle nozzle setup is 0.66. So 1 is 0.25, 2 is 0.38, 3 is 0.66 for the Talon and the Vision double action airbrush. Double action external mix. Internal mix, sorry. I'm looking at the H and thinking external mix, sorry. All right. This is the Paasche H single action, and this is the Paasche VL double action siphon feed internal mix, which means the paint mixes on the inside, the air and the paint together come together inside the gun, but it draws from the bottle like the H does. And the H is, of course, a single action, push the trigger, air and paint come out together. It's mixed outside the body of the airbrush itself. The paint and the air don't come together inside the gun like the double action airbrushes do. Now, the VL is kind of a strange cookie in its own right, in that it is double action, siphon feed, internal mix, the air and the paint come together inside the gun, but it is also double action, but it can be made into a single action airbrush. You can turn this knob, or this wheel rather, this direction, and I don't know if you can see it, but the trigger is moving to the rear slightly. You see it moving to the back. There we go. See it? What it's doing is moving the trigger backwards to where, like, you're pulling back on the trigger to make paint come out. So basically what it does is it turns this into a single action airbrush, and Paasche's, one of Paasche's little touts of this airbrush, it is the world's only double action airbrush that can be single action. I don't know about that. I guess it is. They wouldn't claim it. But what it does, it turns this into a single action airbrush. You put your jar in there, and when you get ready to shoot, you just push down. You already have your paint, your needle is already back that far, and all you're doing is pushing down on this to put the air to it. My thing about that is, if you're going to do that with that, you might as well just buy this. And that way you don't have to fool with a needle, and you don't have to fool with, you know, all that other stuff. Everything's up here. You unscrew this. A quarter turn, all this drops out. You clean it, you put it back. To each his own. Each one has their own thing. I like this airbrush. Put it back where it was. Back into its double action mode. Now, this airbrush is, it's a good airbrush. It's just, if you don't like, a lot of people don't like the, or for whatever reason can't use a double action airbrush as well as they can a single action. It's kind of like walking, chewing bubble gum. I've gotten used to it over the years. It's second nature to me. To me, you have advantages by having a double action gun. Some people don't like it. So, yeah, and there again, to each his own. But at any rate, we're getting off track. The numbering system for the H and the VL are for the needle, nozzle, nozzle cap combinations are 1, 3, and 5. If you have those guns, you know what I'm talking about. The number 1 combo is 0.50. The number 3 combo is 0.75. And the number 5 combo is 1.01 millimeter. We'll just say 1 millimeter. All right? 1 is 0.50. 3 is 0.75. 5 is 1.0 millimeter. That's for the Paasche H and the VL. Now, they make a Millennium, which is a siphon feed double action airbrush as well. It's just smaller. It's a narrower and a little. It's about the same length as any of these, but it's not as big around. Not anywhere near as big around as the H and the VL, and it's actually a little smaller than the Vision, but. I hope that clears up any confusion that you might have with the Paasche airbrushes. The guy also had a VL as well, and he said he never uses it or used it a couple of times, and it sputtered and spit paint and will spit air sometime. And I may do a video just on the VL of a couple of things you can do to make that not do that. And to make it not stick, and I think it's happened more, at least with the more recent offerings of the VL, like say in the last 5 years. I had a VL a long time ago that some way got lost in the moves that we have made over the years, or I have made prior to my getting married 15 years ago. And the VL's been around forever, and I lost it or whatever. And I noticed that with this gun when I first bought it. I've had this one, I don't know, maybe seven, eight years. And I noticed that it spat air and paint, intermittently. And there are a couple things you can do, and I'll touch on that in another video probably, if you want me to, if you think that's something that would help someone, or maybe if you're having that problem with it. This one, I noticed when I was painting, I would pull back and I'd get into a good flow, and all of a sudden it would cut out, and it would cut out just for a split second and then start painting again. Well, I kind of figured out how to fix that problem, and we'll touch on that down the road. But anyway, that's that. Hope that clears that up for everyone. The other thing I wanted to touch on was the new paint that we talked about a couple of videos back from MCW, the new enamels that they have already got over 100 different colors for auto modelers, for military. They have some flats, they have some the glosses, which that's what these are, metallics, pearls, and military colors. I bought about 7 or 8 bottles of it. This is 3 of the ones. This is the black cherry enamel. This is seafoam turquoise enamel. And this is their gloss clear enamel. I wanted to see, wanted to get on the bicycle and ride it and see how it rides. And I tell you, I am really impressed with this stuff. I'm going to bring out, I wanted to try a scrap body, and I didn't have an older scrap body, so I sacrificed my 66, one of my 66 Novas, AMT Pro Street Novas, and I shot a bottle of the black cherry enamel, and this has been probably 3 weeks or so ago, and this is how it come out. Now, this is a gorgeous color. The video is not going to do it justice. This has not been touched. This is straight from the gun to the body, and it's set. And I have not cleared it. I have not polished it. I have not cut and polished. I've not done anything to it. It laid down like $1 million. Now, what I did was, you can go to their website and read their recommendations for thinning and all that. They have a hardener that you can put with it that cuts down on the dry time. I cut this with lacquer thinner, hardware store lacquer thinner, just like I do my Model Master enamels, Tester's enamels, 1-to-1. Dumped this in one of my plastic bottles, filled up the empty bottle with lacquer thinner, shook it up, got all the excess paint, dumped it in the bottle, shook it up, put it in my Paasche Vision at 35 pounds, and shot it, and that's the result. It's got a couple little goobers in it on the trunk deck, so if I decide to keep this, I wish I'd cut these supports out, because now I'm going to have to either take this bottle and touch up if I decide to use it, which I may use this. I mean, this and the metallics, let me tell you, the metallics in this are super, super fine. Perfect scale. Like I said, I can't tell any difference between this and the Testers or the Model Master enamel. So I have found my replacement probably for the enamels. I would like to try the clear and see what it looks like. But you know what? I don't see as you. I wouldn't even clear this, to be honest with you. Cut it, polish it, and I mean, you can see yourself in this, and the reflection is clear. It's not distorted. Like I said, this terrible light in here doesn't do it justice. And this color is just absolutely gorgeous. It's almost a black purple. And I will be doing this on something else down the road or whatever. So, but MCW, go over there and check them out. These were like $6 a piece, a little pricey. You know what? Guess what? I don't mind giving that I mean, the Model Master stuff was, you know, $450. So at Hobby Lobby. So I, you know, $450, $5, $360. Who cares? I don't care. As long as I get what, you know, I want out of it and it does the job. And it, like I said, it lays down and you know, it just did a wonderful job in the airbrush and laid down, you know, smooth and without any issues whatsoever. So, all right, I guess that's it for now. I hope this helps some people. We'll be doing maybe a video on the VL down the road, a little piece. I know a lot of people don't use those anymore, but if you do, if I can help a couple of people, then, you know, so be it. And we'll see how that turns out. If everyone or if you have a VM would like to see that, then we'll do that down the road piece. Okay. Hope everyone has a good work week. I'll get out of here for now. Don't take any crap from anyone. I'll see you soon.